But first, a couple of big plays from last night. You catch any of these? Bucks, Grizzlies, Jamichael Green drives to the basket, dunks all over Ersan Ilyasova.
Now, Nick, I might be with you on this one because he had plenty of time to be able to react. Yes. But this guy takes more charges, so that's probably his best defense.
Ersan Ilyasova, contest or get out the way.
Giannis backing down Justin Holiday, dunks all over Marc Gasol.
Nice little footwork from Giannis. Couple pivots. Marc Gasol can't jump more than a couple 3 inches in the air. Giannis only needs to jump a couple 3 inches, get to the rim. That's a bad combo for Marc Gasol.
Yeah, Marc Gasol got that pizza box vertical. Yeah.
Rockets, Nets, Jared Allen blocked LeBron, Giannis, Blake, AD already this season. Now adds James Harden to the list.
Oh, they was coming to get this one. He got a running start on this one. Harden, you had to know he was right there.
He's the best in the league at this now.
He got one of the better throws, too, we've seen in the NBA.
Oh, in a long time.
Nick, a little in or out?
I'd love to.
Yesterday, Jalen Hurts announced that he was transferring. That's why you were not asked. Transferring from Alabama to Oklahoma. He'll be under the tutelage of Lincoln Riley. So you see, you in or out on Hurts' decision to play for the Sooners now?
I'm all in, Jenna, hands and feet, because what he did with Baker Mayfield, what he did with Kyler, if he can do, because I believe that Jalen is a better quarterback than we've seen. We saw in that comeback against Georgia late. Better thrower of the football, good decision maker. And what's his record, Nick, in college football? 26-2.
Thank you.
All right? I'm in.
Listen, I'm absolutely in for Jalen. Now, I feel bad for the kid who thought he was going to be the next Baker to Kyler, who's now having to go to Morgantown, West Virginia to continue his career.
Oh, get used to that in college football.
Yeah, now with this transfer portal, there's going to be a bunch of this movement. Yeah. But for Jalen, this would be, if he turns into, forget a first round, just an NFL draftable quarterback, this would be Lincoln Riley's best coaching job to date. Because there is at no point that I saw him at Alabama that I thought he was anything other than a really solid college quarterback. I'm very excited to see him at Oklahoma. And, man, we could see a little transfer of power amongst college football with Oklahoma asserting itself near the top of the sport.
On to the NFL. Now, yesterday, Art Rooney II was asked about extending Mike Tomlin's contract this offseason, and he responded, quote, "We'll cross that bridge when we come to it." That's not what we would call a ringing endorsement. Nick, you in or out on the Steelers giving Tomlin an extension with 2 years left on his deal?
The timeline on this is important. I am in. Historically, that is when the Steelers give their coaches contract extensions, not with 1 year left, with 2 years left. There is no salary cap or dead money on coach contracts, so the only risk that the Rooney family would be taking is a financial one, that if you have give an extension and then fire him, you got to eat that money. If you want the organization to have stability and Tomlin to be undercut less moving forward, giving him the stability of we are doubling down on him right now when he is without question one of the 8 best coaches in the sport, I would do that knowing the downside is the Rooney family, you got to cut an extra $7 million or whatever on the check. I'm not worried about that, so I am in.
I'm going to be out because I just don't believe it's real important right now. What's more important is that locker room and stabilizing that. When you have one of your star players that's out of control, you got your quarterback that his leadership has been questioned, why double down on the coach right now? I know who we were, the Pittsburgh Steelers, but I'm just going to chill on that extension right now.
All right. Yesterday, the Jaguars hired John DeFilippo to be their offensive coordinator. DeFilippo was the quarterback coach for the Eagles when they won their Super Bowl last year, so naturally people are wondering if Nick Foles may be joining him down in Florida. CC, you in or out on the Jaguars trying to get Foles?
I'm in because I believe that Doug Peterson, his intel he has on Nick Foles helps him as a quarterback. He's playing the best quarterback that we've ever seen him play, and I believe that DeFilippo can help him with a running attack supported by that defense. Yes.
I'm out for Nick Foles' sake. I do not trust the organizational infrastructure there. I think that is a very tough locker room to corral. I don't know if they are going to get back to the defense they were 2 years ago, because 2 years ago they brought in a bunch of free agents, veterans, who we don't expect are going to be able to continue that level of play into the future. I want a softer landing spot for Nick Foles, maybe a place about 45 minutes from here with the New York Giants, so I am out.
All right, on to the NBA. Boogie Cousins expected to make his Warriors debut on Friday, and he says the Warriors are the most hated team in sports. Nick, you in or out on the Warriors being the most hated team?
I am out because of the Warriors' overwhelming popularity with young people. in America. The team that I think is the most hated team in sports is evidently the nobody believes in us underdog Patriots. It used to be Duke basketball, but Zion doesn't change that entirely. How can you not root for Duke at this point? So I'm out because I think young people like him, and I think it's the Pats.
I think what they've done the last couple years, bringing in KD and then bringing in Boogie Cousins on top of that, they've made the NBA boring. Right now, they're the most hated.
We will end with James Harden. Harden dropped 58 points last night, averaging 35 points per game this season. Only two guards have done that in NBA history, Kobe and Michael. See you in and around on James Harden having the best scoring season for a guard of all time.
No, he's definitely having one of the best. It's been remarkable to watch him, but it's also assisted by the rules. I'm not some old guy saying, oh, man, that's the rule. The rules are easier to score the basketball. That's why we have the scoring spree that we do. No, Michael Jeffrey Jordan, I've seen him not once, but twice, I think, have better seasons than what Harden has had.
To me, I'm out. To me, it's the second best scoring season by a guard all time. It's ahead of Kobe's, and I think it's ahead of Jordan's 37-point-per-game season. That Bulls team won fewer games than it lost more games than it won, pardon me. But the next year after that, after averaging 37, Jordan averaged 35 on a 50-win team that won a playoff series. It was when Jordan was without question asserted himself as the best player in the world. Right now, Harden's season is second to that, so I gotta be out. But it passes Kobe's, it passes even that Jordan 37-point season. He's having a remarkable run. What Jordan did in that 87-88 season was no one has touched it yet from that position.
All right, let's take a break. Coming up, is the Saints offense too much for the Rams to handle? Next on First Things First. What?
That was my first year in pro sports.